My name is Aubrey Sneed, Minister Aubrey Sneed. I got my ordained ministry license, actually, in federal prison 2 years ago. So, you know, it's okay. But I would be remiss if I didn't come up here as a man, as an African-American man, and say a few words, and I will not be long, because I know it's hot. But how many people know that the most important position or office in a democracy is the office of public citizen? It's not President Obama. It's not Brother Holder. It's you, it's me, it's us. We hold the power, we hold the ability to influence change. So therefore, when I fall on my knees tonight and make praises to the Most High, I'm going to thank God for each and every one of you that took the time out of their day to show up. Just showing up is a one good first big step. I guess for me, I'm here today as a minister seeking a spirit of understanding, seeking a spirit of direction, because I don't understand how an unarmed teenage kid can be walking from the store with Skittles in a drink and shot dead in the street. I don't understand how his body can lay in a morgue for several days unidentified before he's even thought about. I don't understand how police, seeing a dead body, cannot go door to door and knock and say, you know this kid? You know this kid? He's dead. I don't understand how a prosecutor can prosecute against a lady shooting a warning shot.
That's right.
You've heard it.
That's right.
To keep her abusive husband over, the same one that oversaw this Zimmerman deal, and then not have the courage to even step up as the lead prosecutor to go against Zimmerman and what I call and what I see was a thrown case. Everybody knows that she's a Tea Party Republican, and so is the governor of Florida, a Tea Party Republican. I don't understand that. I don't understand it. I don't understand a variety of things. I don't understand how Trayvon's dead body can sit in a morgue and be drug and alcohol tested while Zimmerman goes home scot-free. I don't know if Zimmerman was smoking crack, using heroin, smoking reefer, drinking liquor. We don't know. Because he was never called to give a sample. But yet a dead young man was drug tested. I don't understand that. And it hurts me. As a minister of the Most High, it hurts me. So I'm here today looking for and requesting, and I know the Father honors this, a spirit of understanding, a spirit of direction. I can say this, and I'm gonna land the plane. What we're dealing with, in my humble opinion, is a condition of the heart. Let's use some mental magic real quick, and I know you all can connect with this in some capacity. If you were driving your vehicle home, through your watch program or wherever, and you see a young person walking with Skittles and a drink, and you know it's raining outside, why not pull the car and say, young man, it's raining, you need a ride. Now it's up to him to, you know, kick the rap bobo and all that, but I, as an adult, took and used the opportunity to reach out to a young person. So it's a condition of our heart. And in closing, I will say this, since I'm looking for a spirit of understanding and direction, that the scriptures inform us and teach us and instruct us to lean not to our own understanding, because I don't understand it, but to acknowledge him in all of our ways, and he will direct our path. So that's what I'm calling on today, Father, direction and guidance. to get through these troubled times. Thank you.